Welcome back to another episode of Bush TV. Today we got Umama and Monoma.
Mohalo kutoka.
Unjani msanje?
Siphilile, sibulela ukuvela igama lithi into okuhle.
Yeah, it is a pain. So, who are you, man? What are you here for today?
You know, I am Alice King. The Education USA Advisor of employed and by the US Embassy, US Consulate, with the Department of State. The reason why I'm here is because my duty or my role is sending students to study in the United States, be it bachelor's, master's, and PhD. You realize that I didn't mention honors because in the United States there are 4 years for a bachelor's degree. So from bachelor's to master's to PhD. But today specifically, I want to just encourage people to know that Cape Town is going to host more than 30 universities from the United States on the 30th of September. So we want the young people to tell each other to go on fire to know that. More than 30 universities from College of Cape Town will be here to recruit and also to share the programs that they offer from their universities in the United States.
Wow, that is amazing. So they will be here trying to have long abandoned love and
overseas, if you get bars back, Uba Mundana, all from grade 11 and 12. Lunga, over now, so John, was a couple like to other relationships.
And how do they come with that information? How do they get that information?
You mean the children of the schools?
So the schools and the children.
Okay, the schools work directly with me.
Oh, okay.
So, city, it can turn the potential. When in nation there to ifun pazani swai fear, we are bringing hope back to our young people. See there are opportunities outside this country. There is still life beyond here. So in the universities, it is on certain one of the potential book of Sika for 7 years. We attend workshops, they train in the America. Masses of all the students in person. By the way, we have sent more than 2,000 in 2017, 2018.
Wow, so
we've been doing it now. It's not starting now. And the students now are hearing from us and we are in partnership with the American Corner. American Corner, as you see even outside, my colleagues have been sitting outside to market this, to say, we don't just want to have 2,000 in the coming year, we want to have double. Or triple, because the universities are coming on one day and more than 35 universities.
So everybody who wants to study abroad, whether you may be mature or
yes.
Also mature,
yes.
Anyone who wants to study abroad that has a national certificate.
They go, you got it right. And those universities, we've got a mixture of universities coming. There are universities that pay fully. And there are universities that pay because here in Cape Town as well, we do have parents that can pay something. We do have parents that cannot pay anything. So we are accommodating all the groups. The ones who cannot pay anything and they get full funding. And Education USA, that is the program I'm working for. We also buy tickets for them when they travel. Return tickets to the United States.
For all the details of the passport.
Just have the passport and then, yes, in the trick and being ready, being excited, not being fearful because you know everybody can take risks. I am an example because I started in the United States and I came back and the mindset, you know, what I had in mind was like, let me go back and tell people, this is possible and we can go there and come back and
be part of the community. Even when I was matured, you know, you get scared to apply for schools because you don't even know, you don't have information, no direction.
No direction, nothing, because we needed, I didn't even have an advisor, I was just curious.
Mm-hmm.
We are bringing up, as in fact, sparking curiosity from Abandonabin to Abahaz Buti. We are from Abandonabin. Right today, I've been talking to so many young people outside that you say, don't ever think when opportunities come, they are not for you. They have start from yourself and then share to others. When you speak, you say, if you're going to sit out, put when, I get to the US. This is what is going on. Umbati, if as if one, I'm not sure. Ukuthi ndimlo. It when I get the room to sing and a picture in the refrigerator and we beg about it. Ndimlo, send me out the America. We picture.
You know, just in case I don't step all into your way, you know? But how can we get a hold of this information? Because I know some of them may not be, some of them may not be able to be able to watch this on online tonight. So how are they able to get a hold of this information?
We know the education USA Cape Town, say myself, has been very, very generous with my number because our students for the past 7 years, parents, principals, schools, everybody in the community has been very, very respectful in dealing with the cell phone number. I give them the cell phone number and also the email address. My cell phone number I can give to them, they can reach out to me on WhatsApp. Because I'm always on the route of this one thing or the other. So I do have the 071-605-8758.
071-605-8758. 8758. You heard that, guys?
Yes, and also the email address.
Yes.
Which is my surname, which is King.
King.
Then the initials I'm so that A, another A and K. At state.com. So it's King AAK at state.gov. That's how they can get hold of us. We can even send a flyer about the college fair.
Yes,
and also, then. Yes. And also, because I know that you can run away from the fact that there's media, social media, and all those things work well. So many people go green, they don't want paper.
So can I ask you something though?
Yes.
With prelims have been just passed.
Yes.
And finals coming.
Yes.
How are the ones in this matric, specifically in the 2019 matric, are they able also to apply?
Those are our targets.
Okay. So even though matric, yeah, those are
then you go the joint report and the other progress reports over the years are enough for the application. So it is showing, that is showing the schools that they are capable or are able to make it there. So by those, I mean the reports they get, that's how they get accepted. Then when they start now, let's say end of the year, they pass. They just combine whatever they get, whatever that's been there. So those who are in matric, apply now. You are good. Don't wait for December, apply now. And one good thing, you don't have to travel in general, it's like you have to get here because the academic year in America starts in August to May or June, I mean September to June.
Okay, so all they need is to make sure that they should be on the
paper. Yes.
Thank you, Mama, for coming through. Thank you, Mama.
We truly appreciate it. Thank you so much.
For sharing all of this.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. And we are like wishing to see our young people looking at this opportunity. There is still life ahead of them. Whatever is happening around them mustn't scare them. There is life, and the reason why here as adults, we are watching them grow.
Yes.
We are going to support them.
Thank you for the wise words, Mama.
Thank you.
I hope to see you soon.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
And we're back into Mom Ellis Kim for sharing that with the education. But now we're saying with Sisti, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. So glad Sisti to come to the foundation, playing for change, and she's a vocalist. So please tell us about who are you and why you're here today.
Okay, I'm a vocalist, originally from Gugulethu. I'm part of a movement. It's a movement called Play for Change. We build schools around the world, the very first school being in Gugulethu.
Okay.
Yes. These schools are built because they have Gugulethu. We have kids that do drugs, gangsterism and stuff like that. So the purpose of the school is to actually get them out of that and give them a skill that could make them be breathless in clinic, be able to perform
and
to get out of trouble and drugs and get used and killing one another. So what we do then, I'm the music entity of the foundation, but it's the foundation that is the band. The band consists of plus minus 10 to 12 musicians. Musicians of which are coming from different parts of the world. Me being from South Africa, you got Congo, you got Ghana, you got France, you got Israel, you got New Zealand, you got Amsterdam.
It's all around the
world. All around the globe, you got USA in there. And the bosses that are actually that started the foundation are from the United States of America.
Okay.
So what we do, the band goes and we go on tour. When we go on tour, we do benefit concerts of which the proceeds are going to the schools that are built around the world, depending on what the need is of a particular school. And then those proceeds, they go to that following need. And then whatever is needed, and then it's for the kids. We also have a community on Facebook following this movement, of which people, they donate. The community of Facebook for me, they donate as to whatever is needed, the way they can.
So it's not just cash or things, it's just everything that is really needed.
Yes, that is really
needed. The music instrument, the food, or
exactly, whatever it is.
So how did you get involved in such a great organization?
I got involved when they came to open the school here in Gugulethu, South Africa, Cape Town. And I was invited because I had a duo with one of the guys from Poland, coming from the same stable, music stable, because I'm a vocalist. So I was invited to perform at the opening of the school. And since then, that was like in 2009, if I can be exact. 2008, 2009, yes. So I've been part of this movement ever since. We have now officially 15 music schools around the world. The last one being in Curitiba.
Yes. I was about to ask, where is Curitiba? Because I've never heard that in
this.
And you said you performed there? Did you firstly perform your arts and your music that side?
Since we are a group of different musicians, we all have our albums, of which some we do perform some of our original songs, and then we do cover songs like I Was Standing By Being, like One Love, Trying To Unite The World, you know, because there's so much happening, because politics can never actually unite us all. But music is a form of Music is a form of
unification. Everybody.
Yeah, it can unite everybody.
So you actually have all solo artists in at the same time.
In
a band.
Yes.
And you guys did 20 events. Someone can pick their own solo little song. And
exactly, you said.
Wow, that's pretty cool. And how does your career go? Like, what is it that we can hear from music? What is it that you have coming from? Tell us about your albums.
I released my album in 2007, that was my very first album.
Mm-hmm.
Sad to say I haven't released another one. It is overdue, So it is not overdue, actually, but I'm in the pipeline of doing exactly that.
Okay, yeah, so you're working on new stuff, right?
I'm working on new stuff, yes.
Okay, you got some collabs there?
I've got some collabs there. I did a song with one guy called Mischief Girl that I passed on. He's a Zimbabwean rapper that brought a lady, but she also passed. He brought her onto the music scene. So we had a song because, you know, this is xenophobia playing right now. It happened back then again. Also, so we created that song.
But it should stop playing on air.
It should stop.
Because it's going to bring us together.
Yes, sir.
We need that.
Absolutely.
We need that.
Absolutely.
And can you expect any seeing you anywhere?
At present, we don't have venues. Sorry to say. Because my normal venue would be at the Crypt. Up in the Street number one. Mm-hmm. But then at the present moment, it's just getting refurbished. So probably October, November, you'll start seeing me around there.
How can people get a hold of you guys? How can people get a hold of Playing for Change? Because, you know, people need to come in for like yourself, they want to donate, you know, see what's happening and what you guys are really doing.
Yeah, you can all find us on Facebook. Playing for Change on Facebook. PlayingForChange.org, the website. Titi Tsira, you find on Facebook as well. That's where you can find my music. Playing for Change, even on YouTube, you can find my music, even on iTunes. My album will be called Passion, Titi Tsira Passion, the one I released in 2007. Playing for Change got a lot of music that they record around the world. But what they do, they record. They use one song. Let's say, Who Stand By Me. And then our artist includes probably in Cape Town, wherever in Cape Town, can sing maybe a verse. And then they move from there, and they go and record in Brazil, Sao Paulo, someone else recording another verse. And then they move from there, they go probably to Spain, and then someone quietly records the chorus. They move again, you know, that's what they do. So they record musicians all around the world. Record these. And then we also have every September, every year, we've got an annual gig called the Playing for Change Day. So it happens all around the world.
So when is it going to be?
It only happens on the 21st, but it wavers. Yeah, more from it.
1920 to 21.
Titi Tsira, you find on paper on Facebook, you find on Instagram, not much on Twitter.
Not much on Twitter,
but you play with my Facebook and my Instagram, you can find it.
Thank you, Sissy, for coming through today and telling us about what they have changed and about your personal career as a vocalist.
You find it?
Okay. Thank you, Cynthia, for coming through today and telling us to Play for Change. We'd love to hear from you guys again. We'd love more of your music. We'd love to hear your music too. I hope you share it with us. But thank you for coming through today.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you guys for watching another great episode of Bush TV. And thank you, Cynthia, for coming through. Thank you to Miss Alice King for also coming here from the American Corner. And remember, guys, we have an event happening on the 30th of September right here at the American Corner with 30 universities are going to be taking South African kids and making study abroad. So please, guys, whoever is doing a trip right now, is it a passport trip? If you guys are doing a trip certificate, please come to the American Corner on the 30th of September and see if you can go study abroad. Thank you, guys.